just, how people just fall after the world. They see everything in the world, though. People want to be back. Oh, we falling after the world. The white man taught us the 4th of July. We celebrate the 4th of July. If we love God, we're going to come back to these commandments every day.
Read what you got, bro. 1 John 2 and 10. Listen to this. The book of 1 John, chapter 2, verse 15. Read. Not the world.
I said, don't love the world, read.
Neither the things that are in the world.
He said, don't even love the things that's in the world, read. Because what's in the world?
If any man love the world.
He said, if any man love the world, read.
The love of the Father.
The love of the Father.
Is not in him.
The love of the Father is not in our people if they love the world, read up.
And the world passes away.
It said, the world passes away, read.
And the lust thereof,
read.
Be ye that do the will of God abide forever.
So, but whoever do the will of God abide forever. What's the will? Psalm 40 verse 8. It said the world passes away. And love thereof. You see love down here. It's love that's going on. This is pleasure. This ain't spiritual. Man, we got to wake our people up, y'all. We on a path to destruction. We're killing each other. They doing all the killing. They doing all the crimes against each other. Our men get out with pregnant Levi, big women. Our women, how many of y'all married out here? How many of y'all married? It's about the man's supposed to marry. You know, we don't marry our women no more. When you go to Hebrews 13, read that real quick. Let me show you the will of God. Read what you got.
Read out.
Psalm 40 verse 8.
Book of Psalms, chapter 40, verse 8, read. I delight to do thy will, oh my God.
Read.
Yea, the law is within my heart.
So the will of God is his law. David said, I gotta have delight to do thy will, oh God. Your law is within my heart. Now let me show you something. Let me, Yeah, Hebrews 13 and 4. Hebrews 13 and 4.
Read up.
Check this out, listen. Because y'all say, neither one of y'all ain't mad. Listen to this.
Look at Hebrews chapter 13, verse 4.
Read.
Marriage is honorable in all.
It said marriage is honorable. That's an honorable thing, read.
And the bed undefiled.
When you marry, the bed is undefiled. Remember, God said anything that defiled will not enter the kingdom of heaven. So if you ain't married and you doing everything outside of marriage, read up.
But whoremongers.
He said whoremongers. Does that mean they like to sleep with a lot of women, read?
Read up. And adulterers.
And people who like to sleep. A man that like to sleep with another man's wife. Or a woman that like to sleep with another woman's husband, read.
God will judge.
God gonna judge them. Marriage is all for me. This is what we are here to do to show our people. Man, you can get some people. It ain't gonna be no man's strong tonight. But it's gonna be fornication strong tonight, though. It's gonna be fornication strong tonight. And see, we don't try to judge nobody by the way they look, but go to Ecclesiastes 19 and 29. I'm gonna show you what the Bible says. We out here, we doing, we showing our people their sins. God said, show the architect their sins and their transgression. Because it's time to wake up. Because destruction coming to the place and our people are not ready, right? You ready for war? They cut the water off. You got some water to put up. If you can't go to the grocery store, how you gonna feed that little baby? Man, we gotta wake up to our best of God. Imagine your little baby, huh? Man, we gotta wake up. Imagine your heart. We gotta wake up and come back to God. And we're depending on these nations for everything, and they hate us. Read what you got.
Ecclesiastes chapter 19, verse 29.
Read, and this why it's important for y'all to wear modest in the world. Because y'all some nice humble sisters. Man, yesterday I had a female telling me out here, yeah, I know you want to help me. But y'all some nice humble sisters. And look, and see, the way you dress, somebody will judge you differently for the way you live. Like, I'm over there. And you don't call you out your name and all that. But this is what the solution is that the one body of God. And the reason why, because this scripture say this, read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 19, verse 29.
Read.
A man may be known by his look.
God said a man may be known by his look. When these men walking up and down the street, when they're looking at these women, they're like, I want to hit that. He said, I want to marry her. I want to make her my wife. I want to have kids and grow old with this woman. I just want to hit that. Read out.
Read out. And one that hath understanding by his countenance.
And one that hath understanding by their countenance. I can tell you got understanding.
Read. When thou meetest him.
Read.
A man's attire.
But God said a man's attire. What they were on, read.
And excessive laughter.
And excessive laughter, read.
And gait,
read.
Show what he is.
Show what they is. Some men's attire, when you look at a person's attire, he show what they is. So that's how people look at us now. Just like this sister right here, look at this sister. She could be a decent young woman. Hell, she could be a virgin for all that. But what he looking like, oh hell no. But what the hell she got on, what she got on, a brother look at her like that and be like, hell no. So what we gotta do, if we love the Lord, we gotta repent. We gotta come back to these commandments. Y'all eat unclean food. Eat pork, shrimp, lobster, ham leg, oyster. You eat.
Leviticus chapter 11, verse 46.
Read.
This is the law of the beast.
So God gave us laws about beasts.
Read. And of the fowl, and of every living creature.
So certain birds, certain animals. Read.
That moveth in the waters.
The stuff that's in the water, the fish that's in the water. Read.
And of every creature.
Read.
That creepeth upon the earth.
Read on.
To make a difference between the unclean and the clean.
God wants us to make a difference between the unclean food and the clean food. What?
And between the beasts that may be eaten and the beasts that may not be eaten.
And the beasts that may be eaten and the beasts that may not be eaten. Why? Go right back to Leviticus chapter 20, verse 24. Let me show you why. So, if you love God from this day on, you're going to stop eating pork. You're going to stop eating shrimp, lobster, crab legs. If you love God, you gotta stop eating it, because guess what? I'm gonna show you something. Read. You remember that word abomination we read about? And you can't get the kingdom if you're abomination. A lot of people think this Bible ain't no truth. This is the only truth book on the planet, girl. You see how that white woman ran, did it? That's the spirit of Antichrist. She didn't want to confess that. She didn't want to say Christ. Now, we ain't saying this Christ. This is an image. This is what we draw. Why they couldn't draw it the same? They got Lil Nas of the Beach to draw that. That's Caesar Bonjour. We draw that up. That's from sitting up there reading about. Like, okay, Michael there. Skin like friends that burnt in the furnace. Red eyes. And they draw it up. Read what you got.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 24.
Read.
But I have said unto you.
He said, but I say unto you, read.
Ye shall inherit the land.
The Most High trying to give us the kingdom. The kingdom of heaven. Read.
And I will give it unto you.
Read.
To possess it. A land that floweth with milk and honey.
The Most High trying to give us, we in our own land, right? We in our enemy land. He said, I'm trying to give you a land that floweth with milk and honey. Read.
That's right.
I am the Lord your God, which has separated you.
He separated us from other people. Why we still trying to be equal to these people? He made us stronger. We better than them. Everything we do better than them. Y'all know.
Read on. Which have made you separate from other people.
He said, I separated you from other people. Read.
Ye shall therefore put difference.
He said, so you gotta put a difference what?
Between clean beasts and unclean.
You gotta put a difference between the clean beasts and the unclean beasts. Read.
And between unclean fowls and clean.
And clean, unclean birds and clean birds. Read.
And ye shall not make your souls abominable.
He said, don't make your souls abominable. Going back to being abomination, just like worm pans is abomination. Read.
By beast.
By beast.
Or by fowl.
Read.
Or by any matter of living thing.
Read.
That creepeth on the ground.
Why?
Which I have separated you as unclean.
So if whatever he separated us to be unclean, we don't supposed to eat. Why ain't we don't supposed to eat it, read?
And these shall be holy unto me.
This is how we be holy to God. You want to be holy? You want to be righteous? You want to be to the Most High? You want to serve the Lord? Because see how people say we love the Lord, but the only way to love God is to keep His commandments. Because when you go right back, all the scriptures say that. When you go to John 15, this is the word he said. This is the word the Messiah said. John 15, verse 20.
Read out!
Okay, read what you got. Listen to this.
The book of John, chapter 15, verse 12.
Read.
This is my commandments.
Is that what?
This is my commandment.
Read.
That you love one another as I have loved you.
Read. Now, 14 and 15. My fault, 14 and 15. John 14 and 15.
Ye are my friends.
John 14 and 15. John 14 and 15. Now listen to Christ,
The book of John, chapter 14, Verse 15, read. And to love me.
God said what?
Keep my commandments.
He said, if you love me, keep my commandments. The only way we can prove our love to God is by keeping his commandments. Why? Give me 1 John 2 and 3. Let me show you something. 1 John 2 and 3. 1 John 2 and 3. I mean, 1 Samuel 2 and 3, my problem. 1 Samuel 2 and 3. So, the only way we can prove we love God is by keeping his commandments. The most I ain't gonna know that our words and our mouth. You know, if you've been to Christian church, I love them all. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. But they're breaking all his commandments, right? They even teach that God loves the only way we're right. And we want to see them proud. All that talk, it's time for us to stop talking and do what?
Let not arrogance come out of your mouth.
Don't let that arrogance come out of your mouth. Don't continue to say you love the Lord and you don't do what?
For the Lord is God of knowledge.
God only deals with knowledge and what?
And by him, actions are weighed.
God weigh our actions. Because we say we got faith, right? You got faith in the Lord? Let me show you something. Give me James chapter 1. Verse 18. Listen to what James said. James 1 and 18.
Read it out, y'all.
Now let's check this out, look.
Book of James, chapter
1. Back, stop right here, 22.
Book of James, chapter 1, verse 22. Read, but be ye doers of the word.
So he said, be ye doers of the word. Don't just be a hearer out here. Be a doer of the word, read.
Not hearers. Read, only deceiving your own selves.
Because when you just hear the word, out of all this stuff that came out, if you just hear the word, you're deceiving your own self.
Works.
He said, show me that faith without thy works. So you got to take action. You just can't show God your faith without no work, without no action. Read what you got.
And I will show thee my faith by my works.
And James said, look, I'm going to show you my faith by my works. Hey, how you doing, bro? How you doing, bro? Hey, what's wrong, bro? What's up, man? You know, how you speak English? Who speaks Spanish up here? He speaks Spanish?
So good.
I want to ask you this. What tribe are you from, sister?
I'm Dominican.
You're Dominican? Okay, so you're from the tribe of what? According to God. Yeah, you're from the tribe.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah, you're from the tribe of Syria. So now y'all know what tribe you're from.
That's
so
right.
Y'all know what tribe you're from, sister.
Judah!
You're from the tribe of Judah. And see, that's what we out here doing. Because look, go to Jeremiah 17, verse 24. That's the point, because you know what? Y'all names was changed by who? The conquistadors. You gotta ask yourself, what language did we speak before the conquistadors came and taught you in school? What language did you speak? Did you know that y'all spoke Hebrew? Did you know y'all spoke Hebrew? Now listen to this.
Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 4.
Listen to this, read.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thy heritage.
So the true heritage that God gave us, now believe it or not, we brothers and sisters back. All of us family, all of us belong to the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
No matter how light you is, no matter how dark you am, because guess what? We different shades of brown. Yeah, I thought he was from Judah. You know what I'm saying? I thought he was Judah. You know what I'm saying? Read up.
That I gave thee,
really?
And I will cause thee.
So he said, we're going to discontent you from the heritage that he gave us.
And I will cause thee to serve thy enemies in the land, which thou knowest not.
So we're talking about to serve our, did not the Dominicans have to serve in the on the white plantation in San Diego. They had the server on the white plantation. So y'all have people tell you, all of the same people y'all chose the people of Israelite. And we gotta repent from back to the laws that you get today. Now I know something about the tribe of Simeon. Y'all love them tattoos. Let me show you something.
I
I am not coming to destroy, but to fulfill.
You said I ain't coming to destroy, but to fulfill. Because when you go to secondhand,
you got to say the word. I'm going to show you something. Listen to what Andrew said, right? What is it? I ain't come to destroy, dog. But to fulfill. Listen to what Andrew said.
Chapter 7, verse 20. For there, we need the
perish. It say for that what?
For there, there be many that perish in this life.
It say for there be many that perish in this life.
Why? Bring it out, huh?
They despise the law of God. Because they despise the law of God. There's going to be many people that perish in this life because they despise the law of God. What they do? Mark 7, verse 6. I'm going to show you why people despise the laws of God. That's why we so messed up now. If our people were keeping God's laws, our community would be way better.
That's right.
It wouldn't be no black on black crime. It wouldn't be no STDs.
That's right.
It wouldn't be no whoremongering, adultery, or fornication.
That's right.
They just legalized gay marriage in 50 states. And you know they're going to start teaching that in the schools. Y'all got little kids. You want your son growing up be gay? Hell no, you want your daughter to be gay?
No.
But see, they're gonna teach that in school.
Check it out.
They've been teaching that in school. Like, yeah, you know, it's alright. You know, Adam and Steve. They're gonna teach that in school. So now, as you see this world change, you gotta teach them God's law. So they won't get up and won't get something to this world.
Mark chapter 7, verse 6. He answered and said unto them,
read,
but have you liars prophesied of these hypocrites?
Now, the Most High said a bunch of our people hypocrites. He said Isaiah prophesied of a lot of hypocrites.
As it is written, this people honor me with their lips.
God said, my people honor him with their lips, just like in the church. They honor God with their lips, for what?
But their heart is far from me.
They won't take no action. Faith without works is dead. Read.
How feeble in vain do they worship?
The Most I said, my people worshiping me in vain.
Read. Teaching for doctrine.
Teaching for doctrine what?
The commandments of men.
But what men? What they teaching you in church? They what? The law done away.
Bring it out.
You know they had that image in that church that the damn white man shot up? So that was not praying to him and he shot it up.
Bring it out.
So they let you know that what? All the hidden churches. They should have let you know all the time. After that happened right there, God ain't in the church. Seven churches that got burned down in 1 week. God ain't in these churches. God right here in the midst of me and you right now.
That's right.
Bring it out. What we've been reading the whole time you've been out here? The Bible. We've been reading the Bible for 2 hours straight. Scripture. We ain't getting you no bill, man.
That's right.
We ain't clapping. We ain't singing. We don't got no damn 10% fucking coming around.
The commandments of God.
He said, Christ said, our people lay aside the commandments of God. For what?
The old tradition of men.
To uphold the tradition of men. And the tradition of men has taught you God to keep God's law.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.